The Solari Report 2016 annual wrap-up will be published throughout the month of January. This coming Thursday, I will present my introduction and overview, and Dr. Joseph Farrell and I will review the first part of News, Trends, and Stories, which will include economy and financial markets, geopolitics, and culture. The following week, we'll do part two, which will include science and technology, unanswered questions for 2017, and inspiration. I'll also present my And the Winner Is section covering Hero and Movie of the Year, as well as Best Books for 2017. And then get ready, scenarios for business and investment strategy in 2017. In the third week of January, I'll turn to the financial markets and using the 2016 charts that you could find in your annual wrap-up web presentation, I'll do my equity overview and then address Rambus's blockbuster chartology, his first of the quarterly blockbuster chartologies he'll do for us in 2017. And I'll talk more about how our scenarios for 2017 apply to the financial markets. Then in the fourth week, our main theme, the global food harvest and what it means to investors. Food is at the heart of the question I ask throughout the next 4 weeks and throughout our written presentation for the 2016 annual wrap-up. Can we rebuild our local economies as we re-engineer government budgets from a negative return on investment to a positive return on investment? There is an urgency to this question as the heat has turned up in the slow burn, and now with the U.S. presidential election behind us, we enter the pressure cooker of ongoing controlled demolitions of financial liabilities that cannot be funded, of pension funds cutting benefits, insurance companies canceling policies, and businesses laying off large numbers of employees, closing down or declaring bankruptcy. For many years, we've talked about the financial coup d'etat moving assets out of existing systems before the boomers retired into what I call Global 3.0. Last year, we focused on space as an important area in Global 3.0, where I believe some of those resources are being invested. This year, we focus on the endgame in the existing government and legacy systems, or what I call Global 2.0. The financial coup d'etat has moved the assets out while leaving the liabilities behind. Now pension funds and retirement systems, as well as governments throughout the developed world, must manage their way through trains of obligations that are coming due. However we manage the relations between creditors, retirees, shareholders, and taxpayers, whether at the local, state, or national, or even corporate level, the bottom line is we will all do much better if we stopped wasting time and resources and combine the best of traditional ideas as well as new technology to significantly improve our productivity. As we discussed with John Rappaport, Can We Make America Great Again? There is an enormous opportunity to do so. However, whether it is the president-elect asking questions about why we're spending $4 billion on Air Force One, or a CalPERS pension beneficiary asking why their benefits are being cut 60% from $49,000 to $19,000 a year with very little warning, the time has come to ask very serious questions about how the money works around us, to do what we can to make it work better, and to be prepared to shine the light and deal effectively with those who steal, waste, and shrink the pie. For the first time after many years of annual wrap-ups, I'm not going to tell you that there is a good chance we will slow burn through the next year. Change is here, and while 2017 is a transition year, the variability of what could happen over the next few years is high. The heat is turning up, we are headed into the pressure cooker, and it is our choice as to whether we cook up a positive, human-friendly future or not. For investors, the question is whether the Dow Index will go to 30,000 or 10,000 between now and 2020. Either is possible. So please join me and my guests for the 2016 annual wrap-up full of rich insights that can help you navigate the risks and opportunities before us.